सब्सक्राइब एंड हिट द बेल आइकन फॉर मोर नोटिफिकेशंस।
माय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू बेस्ट वे टू स्टडी। इन दिस वीडियो लेट्स सी ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड ईजी टैक्टिक्स इन ऑर्डर टू सॉल्व एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम फ्रॉम बोट्स एंड स्ट्रीम्स। ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स बिगिन द वीडियो। फर्स्ट, इन ऑर्डर टू सॉल्व एनी प्रॉब्लम लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड फ्यू मीनिंग्स एंड फॉर्मूले ऑफ बोट्स एंड स्ट्रीम्स प्रॉब्लम। ओके, सो फर्स्ट there are two main important words which will be used in every problem, which is upstream and downstream. Coming to upstream, upstream is nothing but, for example, let's think there is a river and there is a boat and there is a person. Okay, this person is traveling in a boat on the river. So for example, if the river is traveling one side and person is traveling opposite side, for example, if river is traveling this side and if person with the boat traveling opposite side, this is called upstream. Okay, so downstream is just quite opposite. If a river is traveling this side and if the person is traveling along with the river in the same side, it is called the downstream. Okay, upstream means person is traveling against the river. Downstream means person is traveling along with the river. Okay, so let the upstream and downstream be clear now. Like, we are clear with these terms now. The speed of the river, let it be V. Okay, let's denote the speed of the river as V, and let's denote the speed of the boat as U. Okay, speed of the river is also called as speed of the stream. Okay, this is speed of the boat. Okay, now let's see what are the basic and what are the most commonly repeated problems from boats and streams. Let's take first question. Okay, for example, let's consider a man is taking 10 kilometers per hour if he wants to travel downstream, and he is taking 20 kilometers per hour if he wants to travel upstream. First, we need to try to understand the question. Okay, a man, when he's traveling on a boat on a river, he is taking 10 kilometers per hour. He is traveling 10 kilometers per hour when he is traveling downstream. Downstream means along with the river. Okay, 20 kilometers per hour he is taking when he is trying to travel upstream. Upstream means against the river. Okay, so now what is the question? Rate of current. Current is nothing but stream. Rate is nothing but speed. Okay, what is the speed of the stream? Let us consider downstream speed as A. Okay, how much is the downstream speed? 10 kilometers per hour. So A is 10 kilometers per hour. Okay, and let's consider upstream as B. B is nothing but 20 kilometers per hour, right? Formula is half into upstream minus downstream speed. Okay, so upstream, we know it is how much rate of upstream is 20 kilometers per hour. Okay, so 20 minus half into minus downstream also we know what is the speed. What is the downstream speed? It is 10. Okay, so half into 20 minus 10 is 10 is 5, sir. Answer is 5. Got it? So this is very, very easy and most basic question. The second question, a boat is traveling 40 kilometers when it is traveling towards downstream, and it is traveling 20 kilometers when it is traveling upstream. So, and for both, it's taking 5 hours each. I'll explain you the question also. First, let's see what is the question. Okay. So now they are asking us to find the velocity of the current. Okay. Now let's understand what is the question. A boat is in 5 hours. A boat is traveling 40 kilometers when it is traveling downstream. A same boat when it is traveling upstream, it is able to cover only 20 kilometers when in 5 hours. Okay, so now we are asked to find the velocity of the current. Velocity of the current is nothing but is the velocity of the river. Okay, so now let's see the basic formula, distance, speed and time formula. Now the formula of speed, see here we have time, we have distance also. They're asking us to find the speed, right? Now the formula of the speed is equal to distance by time. What is the distance? Distance is 40 kilometers for downstream, okay? And with time is 5 hours. So speed is 8 when it is traveling downstream. Okay, so now let's see what is the speed of upstream. Distance is how much for upstream? It's 20 kilometers. Time is 5. Okay, 4 while upstream. Okay, now what we are asked to do, we are asked to find the velocity of the current, right? So velocity of the current can be denoted as VC. The formula of velocity of the current is half into SD minus SU. Okay, this is just a formula. Okay, so velocity of the current is nothing but half into SD minus SU. Okay, SD is nothing but speed of upstream, sorry, speed of downstream. SU is speed of upstream, right? So now let's just put these values because we have already derived all of them, and FC is equal to half into speed of downstream. We have already derived it's 8, right? 8 minus speed of downstream. Where is it? Sorry, speed of downstream is 8. We have already written it. Now speed of upstream is 4. We are just putting the values in place. That's it. Okay, 8 minus I'll repeat if you want. Half, this is the formula, and this is speed of downstream and speed of upstream. Speed of downstream is nothing but 8, speed of upstream is 4. We are just putting the values in the formula. 8 minus 4 is 4, half into 2. Okay, half into 8 minus 4 is nothing but 4, right? So we are just cancelling, and the answer is 2. So the velocity of the current is 2. Okay, now let's see what is the third question. Okay, so coming to the third question, a man is able to travel 18 kilometers per hour in still water. Okay, and it is taking him 3 times of the time to travel downstream, down the river. Okay, now he is asking us to find the rate of the stream. Rate of the stream is how much? Okay, now the formula for speed of the boat is half into a plus b. Speed of the river formula is half into a minus b. This is important formula, friends, so remember this. So now let's think A as downstream, okay, and B as upstream. Just remember, okay. So A is equal to 3B. Why I wrote A is equal to 3B? Because in question he told that it is taking 3 times of the time to travel down the stream. Okay, so that's why it is taking 3 times of the upstream for one downstream. Okay, when traveling down the river, it's taking 3 times. Okay, that's why it is A is equal to 3B. Okay, now let's just use the first formula, that is the speed of the boat formula, and then try to solve the problem. Half is equal to A plus B is equal to 18. This is just the formula I wrote as it is. Why I wrote in the right-hand side 18 is nothing but 18 is the like the distance the man traveled 18 kilometers per hour. So I just took the formula, and in the right-hand side I've just written this distance. Okay, now just substitute. Let's just substitute. Okay, half into A is nothing but 3B, right? 3B plus B is equal to 18. Half into 3B plus B is nothing but 4B is equal to 18. Now let's just solve this. Let's send 2 to right-hand side. 18 into 2. So 4B is equal to how much, guys? It is 36. So B is equal to 36 by 4, which is 9. So we got the value of B. B is nothing but upstream value. Upstream value is 9. So friends, now we got the value of B. B is 9. What is B? B is nothing but upstream. Okay. So now let's substitute the B value in this statement so that we'll get the value of A. What is A? A is downstream, right? So let's just substitute. A is equal to 3B. 3B in place of B, we got 9, right? So A is equal to 3B, that is 3 into 9, which is 27. So upstream, we already know it's 9. Now what is the value of downstream? Downstream value is A, which is 27, right? Now what is the question? In question, they are asking us to find the rate of the stream. Rate of the stream is nothing but speed of the river. Rate is nothing but speed. Stream is nothing but river. So speed of the river, we already have the formula. We just need to substitute the value of A and B, right? So half into A minus B. A is nothing but 27. B is nothing but 9. 12 minus 9 is nothing but 18, right? So half into 18 is 9. So the question is, what is the rate of the stream? The rate of the stream is 9. Like this, by using all the formulae, we can easily find the answer. Okay, so that's why, friends, I asked you to remember this formula. It's very, very important. So that's it for today, friends. Thank you so much for watching the video till the end. Hope you found this video useful. So these three
Subscribe and hit bell icon for video notification.
my friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, let's see all the important and easy tactics in order to solve any kind of problem from boats and streams. Okay, so now let's begin the video. First, in order to solve any problem, let's understand few meanings and formulae of boats and streams problem. Okay, so first, there are two main important words which will be used in every problem, which is upstream and downstream. Coming to upstream, upstream is nothing but, for example, let's think there is a river and there is a boat and there is a person. Okay, this person is traveling in a boat on the river. So for example, if the river is traveling one side and person is traveling opposite side. For example, if river is traveling this side and if person with the boat traveling opposite side, this is called upstream. Okay, so downstream is just quite opposite. If a river is traveling this side and if the person is traveling along with the river in the same side, it is called the Downstream, okay. Upstream means person is traveling against the river. Downstream means person is traveling along with the river, okay. So let the upstream and downstream be clear now. Like we are clear with these terms. Now, the speed of the river, let it be V, okay. Let's denote the speed of the river as V, and let's denote the speed of the boat as U. Okay, speed of the river is also called as speed of the stream. Okay, this is speed of the boat. Okay, now let's see what are the basic and what are the most commonly repeated problems from boats and streams. Let's take first question. Okay, for example, let's consider a man is taking 10 kilometers per hour if he wants to travel downstream, and he is taking 20 kilometers per hour if he wants to travel upstream. First, we need to try to understand the question. Okay, a man when he's traveling on a boat on a river, he is taking 10 kilometers per hour. He is traveling 10 kilometers per hour when he is traveling downstream. Downstream means along with the river. Okay, 20 kilometers per hour he is taking when he is trying to travel upstream. Upstream means against the river. Okay, so now what is the question? Rate of current. Current is nothing but stream. Rate is nothing but speed. Okay, what is the speed of the stream? Let us consider downstream speed as A. Okay, how much is the downstream speed? 10 kilometers per hour. So A is 10 kilometers per hour. Okay, and let's consider upstream as B. B is nothing but 20 kilometers per hour, right? The formula is half into upstream minus downstream speed. Okay, so half into upstream, we know it is how much rate of upstream is 20 kilometers per hour. Okay, so 20 minus half into minus downstream. Downstream also we know what is the speed. What is the downstream speed? It is 10. Okay, so half into 20 minus 10 is 10 is 5, sir. Answer is 5. Got it? So this is very, very easy and most basic question. The second question, a boat is traveling 40 kilometers when it is traveling towards downstream, and it is traveling 20 kilometers when it is traveling upstream. So, and for both it's taking 5 hours each. I'll explain you the question also. First, let's see what is the question. Okay, so now they are asking us to find the velocity of the current. Okay, now let's understand what is the question. A boat is traveling 40 kilometers when it is traveling downstream. A same boat when it is traveling upstream, it is able to cover only 20 kilometers when in 5 hours. Okay, so now we are asked to find the velocity of the current. Velocity of the current is nothing but is the velocity of the river. Okay, so now let's see the basic formula, distance, speed and time formula. Now the formula of speed, see here we have time, we have distance also. They're asking us to find the speed, right? Now the formula of the speed is speed is equal to distance by time. What is the distance? Distance is 40 kilometers for downstream. Okay, and with time is 5 hours. So speed is 8 when it is traveling downstream. Okay, so now let's see what is the speed of upstream. Distance is how much for upstream? It's 20 kilometers. Time is 5. Okay, 4. While upstream, okay. Now what we are asked to do, we are asked to find the velocity of the current, right? So velocity of the current can be denoted as Vc. The formula of velocity of the current is half into SD minus SU. Okay, this is just a formula. Okay, so velocity of the current is nothing but half into SD minus SU. Okay, SD is nothing but speed of upstream, sorry, speed of downstream. SU is speed of upstream, right? So now let's just put these values, because we have already derived all of them, and FC is equal to half into speed of downstream. We have already derived, it's 8, right? 8 minus speed of downstream, where is it? Sorry, speed of downstream is 8, we have already written it. Now speed of upstream is 4. We are just putting the values in place, that's it. Okay, 8 minus, I'll repeat if you want, half, this is the formula, and this is speed of downstream and speed of upstream. Speed of downstream is nothing but 8, speed of upstream is 4. We are just putting the values in the formula. 8 minus 4 is 4, half into 2. Okay, half into 8 minus 4 is nothing but 4, right? So we are just cancelling, and the answer is 2. So the velocity of the current is 2. Okay, now let's see what is the third question. Okay, so coming to the third question, a man is able to travel 18 kilometers per hour in still water. Okay, and it is taking him 3 times of the time to travel downstream, down the river. Okay, now he is asking us to find the rate of the stream. Rate of the stream is how much? Okay, so the formula for speed of the boat is half into A plus B. Speed of the river formula is half into A minus B. This is important formula, friends. So remember this. So now let's think A as downstream, okay, and B as upstream. Just remember, okay. So A is equal to 3B. Why I wrote A is equal to 3B? Because in question he told that it is taking 3 times of the time to travel down the stream. Okay, so that's why it is taking 3 times of the upstream for 1 downstream. Okay, when traveling down the river, it's taking 3 times. Okay, that's why it is A is equal to 3B. Okay, now let's just use the first formula, that is the speed of the boat formula, and then try to solve the problem. Half is equal to A plus B is equal to 18. This is just the formula I wrote as it is. Why I wrote in the right hand side 18 is nothing but 18 is the like the distance the man traveled 18 kilometers per hour. So I just took the formula, and in the right hand side I've just written this distance. Okay, now just substitute. Let's just substitute. Okay, half into A is nothing but 3B, right? 3B plus B is equal to 18. Half into 3B plus B is nothing but 4B is equal to 18. Now let's just solve this. Let's send 2 to right hand side. 18 into 2. So 4b is equal to how much, guys? It is 36. So b is equal to 36 by 4, which is 9. So we got the value of b. B is nothing but upstream value. Upstream value is 9. So friends, now we got the value of b. B is 9. What is b? B is nothing but upstream. Okay. So now let's substitute the b value in this statement so that we'll get the value of a. What is a? A is downstream, right? So let's just substitute. A is equal to 3b. 3b in place of b, we got 9, right? So a is equal to 3b, that is 3 into 9, which is 27. So upstream, we already know it's 9. Now what is the value of downstream? Downstream value is a, which is 27, right? Now what is the question? In question, they are asking us to find the rate of the stream. Rate of the stream is nothing but speed of the river. Rate is nothing but speed. Stream is nothing but river. So speed of the river, we already have the formula. We just need to substitute the value of a and b, right? So half into a minus b. A is nothing but 27, b is nothing but 9. 12 minus 9 is nothing but 18, right? So half into 18 is 9. So the question is, what is the rate of the stream? The rate of the stream is 9. Like this, by using all the formulae, we can easily find the answer. Okay, so that's why, friends, I asked you to remember this formula. It's very, very important. So that's it for today, friends. Thank you so much for watching the video till the end. Hope you found this video useful. So these three